The hatch between the Japanese Experiment Logistics Module Pressurized Section and the International Space Station is opened, and the Special Purpose Dexterous Manipulator is getting power. So things are looking good on the International Space Station. And here this afternoon to give us an update on all these activities is International Space Station Flight Director Ginger Couric. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. It was indeed a great day yesterday, and we were able to ingress the JLP. The crew did shoot some high-definition video footage, which we'll be downlinking shortly after crew wake today once we get the EVA kicked off.
All right, great. Well, I understand that the crew got ahead of schedule in the JLP commissioning activities earlier this morning. I guess that's what you just told us about.
Yes, they. When you look at the timeline, they mark activities gray when they're complete. And we looked at the today's timeline, and they had marked off several boxes on there. So they actually got several hours ahead of the timeline. So we were able to move up some additional activities from flight day 7 onto today's timeline, as well as plan a repair of a multimeter that the crew initially reported was damaged, and that needs to come home on the shuttle. So we have a lot of time to work with tomorrow, and in preparation for them getting even further ahead, we've identified tasks and future flight days that we could move up.
Will the JLP tasks still mostly be by mission specialist Takao Doi?
Yes, most of them will be by him, and Commander Peggy Whitson will be assisting as well.
Okay. And then moving on to the other mission objectives, now that the Dexter is getting power from Canadarm2, what's the plan for using the Canadarm2 on the second spacewalk of the mission, which is scheduled to start in just a few hours?
Yes, we will be using the Canadarm2 as planned to support the assembly of the arms on Dexter during the EVA. But overnight, right now it is connected to the SPDM. And in the morning when the crew wakes up, the crew will release the SPDM and position it in a position that will be ready for the EVA activities. Following the EVA, we will re-grapple the SPDM and stay that way in the overnight config.
How long will it stay there, do you know at this point?
It will stay there until flight day 8.
Okay. Well, can you tell us a little bit about what the crew is going to be doing on the second spacewalk?
Yeah, and when I explain it, it's going to sound really simple, but they're going to be assembling the arms on the SPDM. And actually, it's going to, we anticipate that it will take a full 7 hours in duration. The assembly of these arms and the configuration of those arms for nominal operations actually is takes a very intricate series of and highly choreographed series of events that must occur. So it will actually take the full 7 hour duration just to assemble the arms.
Okay. And then I guess that's it for that spacewalk, but it's not it for the SPDM assembly. There's one more spacewalk.
Right. We have one more spacewalk scheduled on flight day 8 to complete the assembly of the SPDM. So as you can see, after three EVAs, it's been it's a very complicated piece of hardware, but we're looking forward to having it assembled.
All right. Well, anything else that you think we should know about?
No, other than we're looking forward to the EVA today.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Ginger. Again, that was Station Flight Director Ginger Couric.